Hello, this is Jennifer Moore, Director SAP Solution Sales at CENIT North America, and I'd like to welcome you to the second video of our series on SAP Product Structure Management, also known as SAP PSM. Today, I'd like to give you an overview of how variant configuration in SAP PSM works and how to create necessary dependencies. For newcomers to the series, I'll do a brief recap on why we want to use SAP PSM. Driving factors are typically the need to manage a fast-growing variety of products, the keyword here being lot size one. Then, of course, widespread enterprise thinking in platforms and product families, growing inner complexity of contemporary products with increasing electronics and software, as well as the economic necessity to reuse components and solutions. SAP PSM enables us to tackle all of these challenges and to manage the entire product in just one structure, efficiently and effectively. But how do I get individual products out of the product structure? And how can we see consistent configurations of the product model? This is where variant configuration comes into the picture, and we want to take a look at how this works in SAP PSM. To accomplish that, we have our small example that some of you may recognize from our first video on SAP Product Structure Management, the little car air conditioning device, which served as our example in the previous video as well. You might remember here you see a product structure of 16 possible and 4 valid product variants. Variant configuration tells us what combinations of components form valid products, as you can see here, and what characteristics can be combined and which can't. These dependencies are defined within the engineering process and documented for each technical solution. The characteristics, which are used to define relevant and valid configurations, often stem from the requirements engineering of the product. In our simple example, we'll show 2 configurations. If our car has 1 or 2 climate zones, and if it comes with GPS functionality or not. Schematically, it looks like the following. Let's assume we have 2 climate zones, then the system already knows we need this cover and 1 of the 2 available electronic units. The cooling device is always included, of course. For navigation, we use our smartphone anyway, so we'll leave out the GPS option. Also, we now know which display we need and which electronics unit can be excluded. And our AC device is fully configured. We'll take a look at it in the system now. In that, I want to show you how to create a configuration and at least give you an idea how to easily edit the needed information of dependencies graphically. As you can see here, I'm already in the display function of the product structure of our example AC device, which I'll expand completely before going forward. We see the product items with the corresponding product item variants. And like indicated already in the first video, on the level of these variants, actually, I want to take control of our element once again so we can retrace which dependencies are logged here. This looks a bit cryptic, but we don't have to edit it that cryptically. This means when I'm at the level of the product items, I can easily jump into the edit function for the dependencies of this product item. As you can see, this is solved here with a table. We see the product item with its variants and the corresponding characteristics. Here we see the control elements for 1 climate zone are selected when I select the characteristic 1 climate zone, and according to this logic for the 2 zones as well. This is very minimalistic here, but we can easily check how it looks at the upper level of the whole AC device when I select it. Then we have all the aforementioned characteristics, all product item variants, and can easily edit in this table the dependencies that are needed for our product structure. This, of course, is a precondition for the later configuration of individual products of our product family. We want to take a look at how we can create the so-called simulation, which does just that, applies a configuration by evaluating the respective characteristics and applying them. To do this, I'm going to select Edit Simulation and start by creating a configuration so that I can make this simulation. And then we'll step through the characteristics. We'd like our AC device to have two climate zones. Language is going to be English. The whole thing is going to be for the US market. And we don't need a service to update navigational data since we don't want to integrate the GPS. Okay, I can now activate this simulation. And when I close the editing area, then we should see that we still have exactly the product item variance shown in the product structure that we need for our configuration. Okay, we have the English manual, and we don't have the service for the GPS updates included. We have the corresponding software for two zones, English language settings, suitable parameters for the US, and also our cover, the control elements for the two zones, as is, of course, the electronic component. Now we can see how you can relatively easily add dependencies to the product structures here, and how also this is used to create a product configuration to get the data to a specific product or partial configuration. To wrap it up, we'll take one last look at the benefits SAP Product Structure Management offers. It ensures an enhanced data integration between the different technical disciplines, and with this promotes cooperation and efficiency in engineering. SAP PSM is a comprehensive single source of truth for all product-dependent information and can be an important step towards the digital twin and digitalization. Also, SAP PSM makes it possible for engineering to concentrate on working on innovations rather than being the point of contact for all product-related data. By supporting all possible downstream processes with the best available product data, it can also help improve product quality. This is even more important as the existence of a centralized product structure enables a simplified and more transparent release and change management process. I hope you've enjoyed this overview of SAP PSM's functionality. Thank you for your attention. If you're interested in further details on the functionality of SAP Product Structure Management, like visual support of the product configuration utilizing SAP 3D Visual Enterprise, or other possibilities, like our tool for Excel export of PSM data, please refer to our other videos in this series about SAP Product Structure Management. If you have further questions, please don't hesitate to reach out to CENIT at info@CENIT.com or send an email to our sister company, Caristo, at myquestion@Caristo.com. Thank you and have a great day.